You have to bend your knees a little bit, have the wide stand in your legs, arm in front, so we are ready for the defense like this, what we have been talking about in different tutorials. So in this position, we are ready for the power smash coming. So this is the start position to be in, with the legs out, a little bit bended, the arms out in front of you, the elbow and the wrist in a neutral position like this, ready for the high defense, right? So tip number one in this stroke, that is to be loose in your arm. It can be that you're under pressure, but you can still wait for the shuttle with a loose arm. If you want to add power to the shot, it's also easier for you to add the power with the forearm rotation and the finger power. But in this case, we want it to block to the net. And that means that we have to be loose in all our body, in the movement, in the shot, when we want to place it very, very close to the net. The next tip, that is, when the shuttle approaches you, it's important to mention that we need to move into the shuttle. So moving a little bit forward into the shot. If I do it the other way around, like this, I will be in a very defensive position going backwards. But what we need to do, we want to meet it early, push a little bit forward. Then it's also easier for me to run to the net to try to take the initiative at the net and maybe get the lift again. So the next tip, tip number three in this video, that is when we hit the shuttle, it's crucial that your wrist is in a neutral position and your arm is way out in front of you. So you can meet it early with this movement where I'm using my arm to make the stroke. I don't use finger power like this. It's very tricky for me to control, but I use my loose arm to get position to my shots using this movement. The grip I'm holding is around the bevel grip, maybe the thumb grip, around that area, depending on what you like the most. And the wrist, as you can see here, it's in a neutral position, so I have control about what I'm doing. So my arm is out in front of me, my thumb is controlling what I'm doing, the wrist is in a neutral position. So if I hit it straight on, you can almost see that my angle of the racket is moving a little bit upwards. If I go a little bit too much under it, it will spin too much. So it needs to be somewhere in between where you have the small angle on your racket and you go a little bit from up and down. So you do the slice into the shuttle, not down, not up, but cross forward with this angle. And of course, the smashes coming from the opponents, they can vary a lot. So it can be very tricky for you to adjust. It's not always that the smash will come straight on you. That can be up here. It could be out in the side. It could be out in this side. Still try to add the same move with your arm, the wrist, the thumb controlling, the loose arm, all these things, depending on where the smash will come. Of course, it can also be over here. That's a different technique, but it's the same principle about how you use the arm. It can also be in the forehand side, a little bit from up, cross down, backhand, cross down, all these movements. So where you have control about what your arm is doing and where you place those shuttles. So guys, thanks a lot once again for tuning in to this tutorial. It's truly amazing. Please hit the bell button to get our future content if you like this video and all our other videos. And also go check out Badminton Family Plus. We have over 500 videos on that channel with our e-learning courses. So have a great day, everybody. See you in the next tutorial.